There is some breaking news this evening related to Hillary Clinton's handling of emails while she was Secretary of State. Attorney General Loretta Lynch will follow the FBI's recommendation to not pursue criminal charges. She said in a statement, quote, "I received and accepted their unanimous recommendation that the thorough year-long investigation be closed and that no charges be brought against any individuals within the scope of the investigation." While that appears to put an end to the prospect of legal action, Lisa Desjardins reports on the political fallout.
Candidate Hillary Clinton was out stumping for the presidency on the Jersey coast today, but the Democrat was still taking heat for her time as Secretary of State. This morning, House Speaker Paul Ryan slammed the FBI decision to not recommend charges in its probe of Clinton's private email use, suggesting the nominee-to-be not get classified briefings.
I think the DNI clapper should deny Hillary Clinton access to classified information during this campaign, given how she so recklessly handled classified information.
He was asked, did Clinton get preferential treatment?
I'll let everybody be the judge of that. It looks like it to me.
FBI Director James Comey is also in Republicans' sights. The House Oversight Committee quickly set up a hearing for tomorrow where Comey will testify about the email case. Attorney General Loretta Lynch will appear before another panel next week. Republican presidential hopeful Donald Trump pressed the issue on the trail in North Carolina.
I always felt that Hillary Clinton would escape criminal charges for her dangerous and illegal behavior because I always knew, and I always see, and it's so sad, that our system is in fact rigged. It's totally rigged.
As for Team Clinton, their day today was spent on offense, bidding to move the focus off the email story. Part one of her game plan, tackling student loans. In a statement, Clinton said she's taking a page from Bernie Sanders, proposing to make public universities tuition-free for most American families.
Part two, confronting Trump's business record head-on in a place he knows, Atlantic City.
We're standing in front of the old Trump Plaza Casino and Hotel. Donald Trump once predicted it will be the biggest hit yet. Now it's abandoned. So it's fair to ask, since he is applying for a job, what in the world happened here?
But as Clinton and her campaign fired off their broadsides, Trump responded right away in kind. He issued a statement saying it was common practice to, quote, use bankruptcy proceedings to ultimately save jobs. He continued, nobody understands the economy like I do, and no one, especially not crooked Hillary Clinton, will do more for the economy than I will. Meanwhile, there's one fewer person on Trump's possible VP list, the man he campaigned with last night. Tennessee Senator Bob Corker took himself out of the running. And amidst all this, Bernie Sanders met today behind closed doors with Democrats in Congress, pushing to change the party's priorities. Some reportedly booed him for not yet endorsing Clinton. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Lisa Desjardins.